Welcome back, everybody. Hopefully you guys are having an awesome day and are having a great week. So I just want to say I appreciate the support on the channel and appreciate you guys coming back for more videos. So nothing crazy has happened. I just want to give everybody an update on a lot of the snakes. Quite a few of them shed over the last few days, and then I fed a lot of them off camera. I fed all of the ball pythons, which do feed live. I know some of you guys do like seeing that. You guys like the updates on how they're doing. YouTube doesn't really like the lives, and I get a lot of backlash on it, which is, you know, what an open internet platform is going to get. But, you know, a lot of the baby ball pythons are on live, so it's just what it is. And, you know, I want them to be healthy, but sometimes I will post that. It's not going to be a regular thing. So this is Peaches, my pearl Burmese python. I know that some of you guys have messaged me on Burmese, and I think they're fantastic animals. She is 2 years old this month, so you can see I think she's a really good size. She's shedding well, she's eating well. We've made a pretty good bond together over the last 2 years. You know, she still hisses a little bit when I take her out, but it's a lot better than what it was. So the pearl, if the lighting is correct, it's hard to see on the little camera or the little window on the camera, but it's a albino and a hypo. So, you know, I personally like both of those genes single, and then they look even better mixed together. And I do like the albino. The albinos are super bright and they fade out a lot when they get older, but I've seen a lot of adult female big berms, 13, 14, 15 foot pearls, and they're still very vibrant yellow, very nice bright whites down the side, and her patterns just look phenomenal. Kind of looks like maybe a cheetah, maybe, but she's gorgeous, and I cannot wait until she starts getting bigger. She is on small rats. I'm sure she might be able to eat a medium, but mediums are such a wide range, it's hard to say. I feed her a medium because if you look at Rodent Pro, they go from like 80 grams to like 190 grams on the mediums. So as a medium, she could take an 80 or 90 gram, but she would not, I don't think she'd be able to take anything over 150 grams. Although berms are known to eat very large meals, I am kind of growing her slowly, but she's very healthy, I think. So we'll go and put her back, and then we'll check out some of the other snakes. And we can see right there, Mountain Dew is already wanting to get out, and there's her shed. And so, talked about her cage on a few videos ago, and she's just in a Christmas tree tote. And I know a lot of you guys were saying that you guys have the Christmas tree totes and you like them. I see a lot of people with berms and retics have these. I've seen people not saying that it's the best or ideal. I've seen people with 8 foot or more berms and retics in these, and I've watched Wildfire retics. I do like watching him. He has some pretty cool snakes, and he's actually made a rack system out of these. So he just basically bought wood or PVC and just stacked like 5 or 6 of these in a single slot or row, and it cleans up. It works, and these are only $20 at Walmart, so it's not bad. Mountain Dew right here, she shed, and then we can see this. Remember when I had her over here, which, I mean, these are still a really good size for her at her size, but I was having issues where she was rubbing the tops of the these panels right here, because in here they have the holes for ventilation. And then she rubbed off one of her scales on the top of her head, which is healing. We can kind of see it, but
It's not as bad as it was. And it's almost healed up. It's like right between her eyes. So this girl right here, I do need to get her more water. And then I need to clean her hide because she did poop all over it when she shed. This girl is gorgeous. I love how bright the bands are. The orange and the yellows behind her eyes. So, and as you can see, I just scooped her up and she didn't have any issues. The older Anaconda, by a year and a half-ish, I would say, she's in shed too. So her eyes, she's just starting to go into shed. I know this glass is not helping us out. And it is annoying to slide this open on camera, but her eyes are starting to gloss over and I'm really excited for her to shed because she's getting bigger and bigger constantly, which is awesome. So we'll try to put her back. I'll leave the lid off, so if she wants to explore a little bit, then she can. I guess the same with the Burmese. My only common, I should have turned the lights on, but you can kind of see her eyes are glossed over. She's in shed, she's growing, and she's gonna be really big after that shed. So I'm really excited to show you guys about the snakes in this rack because I've been waiting for quite a while for these snakes to shed out and two of them are taking forever. So we'll show you the ones that are taking forever. Her eyes are still glossed over, but this is a IMG Motley Hypo Jungle. She is 100% het for snow, so she has the Anery and the albino genes hidden in her, which is awesome because I have a male snow, and it would be really cool to hit IMG snows and the moon glows out of this female and this male. So we can make the moon glows with the snow because the snow is Anery and albino, and moon glows Anery, albino, and the hypo, and she has the visual hypo. So she will shed out soon, and she is getting darker. She's 2020, pretty early 2020. When I got her, she was darkish, but now she's really starting to get pretty dark. Some of these IMGs do take a couple of years before they darken up, and some IMGs get dark right out of birth. So it's a really weird gene on how it plays out. This female right here, the moon glow, she just shed, and this girl looks phenomenal. Gorgeous eyes. The patterns and the colors on her are very, very nice. And then she's on the call albino strand. So I've seen snows and moon glows that have the sharp albino in them, and they are a little bit more vibrant. But I really don't see too many people working with sharps like you see with the calls. So you can see the saddles a little bit better on her. She will turn whitish, more white than the snows. And then the snows don't have the hypo, so you can kind of see the saddles. But when he gets older, most of the time snows do get pretty vibrant yellow, and then the whites just look extremely white on them from the offset of the yellows. The VPI IMG, she just came out of blue, I think yesterday, so we probably have about another 3 to 4 days with her on before she sheds, and I will be misting her cage frequently. So she has a good shed in the ARS rack. So now I do have to clean some of these tubs out. They poop. They're all on different feeding schedules. They all pooped at different times. So every day I do come in here and I do spot check and I do clean. I might miss a few, so don't judge me too hard. I will clean up everything that I see. The Superfly Clown 2021, she shed, and this girl looks phenomenal. I really like the yellows and the whites and then the cool clown pattern on the head. So, if you like clowns, I would highly suggest the Superfly. So it's a super pastel fire clown. So some pretty cool genes at play there. And this female shed out as well. So it's a fire and she yellow belly pied. So pretty cool looking. A lot of cool markings just on the top. And I like the head pattern on both sides. It's got the kind of the same pattern. So looks pretty cool to me. She shed a couple of them. Oh yeah, this girl shed very nicely. 2019 Jungle Hypo Pastel. And she's growing slowly. She's a very good eater. She's on wrap-ups, and I'm pretty sure I could even feed her weaned without any issues. But I just keep her on wrap-ups for whatever reason. Maybe I'll switch it up this week to wean, but I love the colors on her. We can see the jungle line. She has a lot of speckling on her, which is awesome. A little bit unique for some of these snakes. And then I do like her, the tail, the colors, and a little bit of black rings around the orange and red, which is awesome. So she sheds almost every month consistently, and she doesn't grow very much, which is kind of odd. VPI Aztec is in shed. So unfortunately, handling with her is on a hold for the next couple of days. Unfortunately, because we need to, you know, build that bond up with her. VPI Jungle, this lady right here, which I love the colors on her and the patterns, and VPI stuff only gets better as they get older. If you guys like her, I know John Chosmer has the siblings to her still for sale, males and females. So if you want a very nice jungle VPI, I would suggest finding him online. And then the pastel clown shed. So again, she still looks good. She looked better as a baby. Most ball pythons do fade out, which kind of sucks. And they're trying to escape, but they're being good. So, oh yeah, two more and then that's it. So the brother and sister, which is weird to say because you can breed the bloodlines in ball pythons without any negative effect. So we'll just say clutch mates. This one was kind of a little hissy, so this is the male Mystic Potion, gorgeous looking, and then the female looks even better. So fresh shed, and it's kind of cool that they shed out at the exact same time as well. And yeah, so a little bit of pee down there, not a big deal. Oh, big pee right there. Okay, so this is the first time I'm actually really looking at her. I looked through the side here and I was like, oh, she shed. So a little embarrassing, but it is what it is. Like I said, they all go to the bathroom, so that will be cleaned after this. I love the freeways and the highways. They are a little pricey. I see the prices go down a little bit on them, but this kind of reminds me of the pattern. So this is the female Mystic Potion. Kind of reminds me of the pattern, which is cool. And they do get better as age, which is weird to say that ball pythons get better as they age, but very, very beautiful. It's got the grayish, purpley hue. Some markings on her side, which will show up as she gets older. And then these lines should improve as well, so. The black pastel shed. So this lady right here is 2001. And we'll try to get the lighting. See if we can get some good lighting over here. And then black pastel 2020. So pretty much a year apart. Big difference, about 600 gram difference. And she started off just like here, which was almost pure white except for the head stamp or the head markings or head colorings, I should say. And then as she got older, which she's not even that old, she started getting the black spots randomly throughout her body. And then every time she sheds, little by little, more of them start to show up. So I'm really hoping it happens with her, but if not, it's not a big deal. But It's kind of cool. So a lot of the black pastel tides are very, 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 very high whites. And then I have seen not too many of them, but some do have one or two spots down the body. It's nothing ridiculous of the coloring, or I just think it looks cool. I like white snakes, but knowing that there's a little bit of pattern on them is what I like. So I'm not really into the super fire stuff unless, I don't know, that could be for another video. I mean, it's cool. But if you want an all white snake, just get a bell. Why spend quadruple the money on a super fire when you can just get one with blue eyes for way cheaper? Unless you're a breeder, unless there's some cool stuff hidden in it, then I can understand why. But not everybody's a breeder. A lot of people are just collectors, and that's perfectly fine. That's, you know, I've been doing this for six, seven years. And, you know, I don't breed at all. So I just collect the stuff that I like. And collecting, people get weird about saying collecting because they're live animals and shouldn't be collecting live animals, but you guys understand. So that is it. I appreciate the support on the channel. Hopefully you guys liked looking at some of these snakes out of shed when we can see the full beauty of them, and their colors are always more vibrant and just very beautiful when they're out of shed. So stay tuned, because I'm very excited for Pop-Tart to shed. It'll probably take her at least 2 weeks, so it sucks because I can't handle her for that long, which is a bummer because she's a gorgeous snake and phenomenal temperament, but I have no problems not holding her for 2 weeks, and then she'll be perfectly fine. So she won't hate me for that. All right, guys, signing off. Hopefully you guys will come back for another video, and I'll see you guys on the next one.